We're here today to consult with the local community, with established neighborhoods, with neighbors, because we are quite interested in their views on the project, to introduce them on our intention, on the design, on the management structure. And it's very important for us, if not the most important thing, to hear their concerns, but also their ideas, to help shape a mutually beneficial project for everybody.
So we've intentionally designed a building that is dynamic, forward-looking, and distinctive, something that the people in the area and Southwark as a whole can be really proud of. The public realm will be hugely affected by this building in a very positive way. Currently there's a single-storey factory building with a hard brick wall really close to the pavement, almost abutting the trees, and the pavement is very broken up, very difficult to navigate. There are a number of opportunities to improve the building here. We're going to pull the building back from the pavement line to make a really wide pavement, really enhance the public realm, give the trees space. We're retaining the trees, which is very important to the character of the area. We'll have really nice design paving, lighting. We'll have an active frontage, because at the moment, as I said, there's a solid brick wall with hardly any windows. We're going to have open space. We're going to have really nice soft landscaping in front of the building, a sort of buffer zone, if you like, the trees, and a much smarter building. And it's just a more civic place that complements the park opposite.
Southwark is already home for world-renowned universities, and therefore there is a big need for well-managed, high-quality, car-free student accommodation in that borough. Students or well-managed student accommodations bring definitely a lot of benefits to any local community. There's the added level of security, because you have 100, 150 pairs of eyes, more. Then there is obviously the economic benefit of additional students, because they also will use the local shops, the local pubs, and of course it brings more vibrancy.
The building won't have a negative impact on the neighbours' views, and there's two strands to that. One is the neighbours' outlook, and one is our building looking at other buildings. We have aligned with the buildings to east and west, so that their views will be completely unaffected. They will not see our building from within their buildings. Our building overlooks the park, so it doesn't overlook any other properties in that sense. There's no negative impact on local amenity.
So we're looking at ways to improve the environment for everybody, so disabled people can use the space socially and learn and get to use Bermondsey. Because generally students are forced to use the accommodation that the universities provide. But it's important as a society that we give people the freedom to choose where they want to live, and give them flexible, interesting accommodation like everybody else gets to have.
We would like to communicate and also hear what the neighbours or the growing local community has to say about it. I think that is a crucial part of making any of our projects a success, having this communication, integration, and hopefully everything turns out into a big success.